welcome to Animal Answers. I'm Felicity McCartney, giving you all the help and advice you need into becoming the perfect pet owner. This week, we're focusing on those oh-so-common pests. Yeah, I think you know what I'm talking about. It's fleas and ticks. Although they may be small in size, they are often a big problem for pet owners.
Fleas and ticks are more common in cats and dogs than any other household pet. This is due to the great amount of time they spend in here, the great outdoors. It is not necessarily the great outdoors where the fleas and ticks come from. It's mainly from skin-to-skin contact with other pets in the park, such as other cats and other dogs. This is more likely with fleas, as they spend most of their lives trying to find a warm place to live, i.e. your pet. So, really, your pet is just merely a form of transportation.
It is important that you check your pets regularly in order to keep them and your home flea-free. Ticks tend to work in different ways than fleas. They tend to travel solo, whereas fleas, when on your pet, they tend to be in groups and they reproduce at an alarming rate. So now I'm going to show you how to quickly and efficiently check your pet for fleas.
First of all, you need a standard flea comb. You can pick one of these up in any pet shop for fairly cheap. Then you need just a bowl of water.
You need to get your pet in a good hold. For the cat, it's good to have them on the arm, and it's probably a good idea to wear a long sleeve jumper as well, just in case they scratch or bite.
It's always a good idea to have a treat or some food nearby, so your pet can be rewarded for any good behaviour. As well, it helps to keep them calm. Stroke your pet gently so they too can relax. You should try everything you can to avoid making this a stressful experience for your pet.
So once you get your cat in a comfy position, just make sure he's nice and calm, give him a good stroke. Just make sure he's calm, you don't want to stress him out. Then get your flea comb and just gently start combing him.
Check the comb regularly for fleas, and if you see one, quickly dip the comb in the water because they do jump very quick.
You need to check every few seconds just to see if there's nothing on the flea comb, because you don't want to be combing when there's fleas on it and letting the fleas get back into the fur. So you want to make sure you check it for fleas, and then if you see any, obviously you've got to be quick, dip it in your water, because the water acts as a pool for the fleas, which basically makes them drown.
Having a wet comb can also help to keep a grip of any fleas that come into contact with the comb.
You also need to keep an eye out for little black bits in the flea comb, because this is flea feces, and this means if it's on your pet, then this could mean that your pet either has fleas or has had fleas recently. You need to look out for your pet scratching. That is the main sign of your pet having fleas, is if they scratch. Another way to look for fleas on your cat without even using a flea comb is to just brush the fur gently back the opposite way.
Brush the fur against the grain, looking in the parting and the skin of your pet, just looking out for any of the black flakes and also just for any stray fleas that you may see. If you find any fleas or flea feces, it is vital that you treat your pet as soon as possible.
Later, I will be visiting the local pet shop to see what treatments there are, so stay tuned.
It is important to know the risks and dangers of fleas and ticks, so you are prepared if you ever come into contact with them. Ticks look like small crab-like parasites that feed off warm, fresh blood. They generally travel solo, but that doesn't make them any less of a risk. Once in contact with an ideal host, they bury their heads deep into the flesh. And it is so important that a tick is removed from the flesh as soon as possible, because the longer it's in there, the higher risk of Lyme disease. Now, fleas are small black parasites, but they do appear red if they have recently fed. The main problem with fleas is that they reproduce at an alarming rate, meaning that one flea on your pet could make 1,000 in your home. It's been known for fleas to pass on tapeworm eggs to animals as well when they bite, so it is always a good idea to treat your pet for worms as well as fleas.
So I'm at a pet shop in Stockport trying to find out more information about fleas and ticks. And who better to speak to than Matt, the pet shop manager. So Matt, what advice could you give to pet owners that are struggling with their pets being infested with the parasites?
Well, there's several flea treatments actually on the market. I mean, there's sprays, there's drops, there's powders, there's tablets. But by far the best one out there is the drops that you put on the back of the neck. Now, you are supposed to repeat this, it's every month, and you've got to really keep on top of it to try and keep the fleas at bay. But you have got to think about other aspects of the flea infestation, because fleas actually only live on the animal for 5% of the life cycle.
Oh right, so they're all the treatments that you can use for your pet if your pet's got fleas. And you've said that they're only on the pet for 5% of the time, so what household treatments can pet owners use?
The best thing you can do is get a really strong household flea spray and just go mad with it. Be really thorough, spray absolutely everywhere. Everywhere the cat likes to go, clothing, bedding, furniture, skirting boards, cracks in the floors, and just be really thorough with it. And if you've treated your house and a couple of weeks later you find a flea, don't feel disheartened, don't feel down, don't feel beaten, just be thorough. Because all it could be a case of, you miss one egg or one larvae, that one larvae's hatched, turned into a flea, laid more eggs, and that all those eggs hatch, and you've reinfested again. But just be really thorough with it and you'll be fine. Remember, one flea can turn into 100 fleas within a week.
So are you saying that it is equally as important to treat your home for fleas and what it is to treat your animal for fleas?
It's really essential that you treat your house, because if you just treat your cat and ignore the house, the fleas will just jump off your cat, lie dormant, or feed off other members of the household. Wait till the treatments wear off, then go back to your cat. I mean, there's loads of other treatments out there. There's powders for your carpet, there's flea bombs that smog your house with smoke. But by far the best treatment is a decent household flea spray, and just be really thorough with it.
Okay, thanks very much for your time, Matt. So, we've learned that every animal is at risk of pest infestation, whether they're long-haired, short-haired. It is equally as important to treat your home as well as your pet, because fleas thrive in a warm home. Next week, we'll be looking at how to manage your pet's winter coat. This has been Animal Answers. I'm Felicity. Thank you and goodbye.